Welcome back to Inside Politics. Our guest today is former Nashville Congressman Bob Clement. He's written a book called Kings, Presidents, Kings, and Convicts. It's now available in bookstores and online. Bob, we talked a little bit about the inmates. Did that scare any of your friends that came over to realize they were being waited on and helped by prison convicts?
You know, it didn't. We had prisoners. So my father's governor had prisoners out at the governor's residence the entire time we were there, and they'd cut the grass and cook the food. And they became very close to me because, you know, Highway Patrol had a job to do, and
one of them stole your car.
Played basketball and football with me, and we'd have pool tournaments, and one of them stole my car. That's true.
Now, it might surprise to people to learn that also while you were at the residence, you not only had a front row seat for Tennessee politics and history, but you also became quite a farmer. Do you continue to be a farmer
today? You know,
today?
I did. You know, President Davis, who was president of Tennessee State University, would always bring us a turkey at Thanksgiving and Christmas every year. And he got me in the farming business, and I had 150 chickens, 50 turkeys, 2 goats, 3 horses, rabbits. Started with 3 guinea pigs and ended up with 150 guinea pigs. I tell all those stories. And I truly was a farmer out there, and I sold eggs, state employees and others, 65 cents a dozen.
If you hadn't gone into politics and public service, would you have been just as happy being a farmer?
You know, I think I would have, because I really enjoyed farm animals and something about owning a piece of property and also having farm animals, and it was very close to me and still is.
Now, you've had such a varied life. How long have people been after you to write a book?
Yeah, I thought about it a long time ago, and thank God I kept good notes, because you forget a lot as you get older. And about 2 years ago, and Bart Herbison, I'll give him a lot of credit, we had started writing a book years ago. Bart is executive director of the Nashville Songwriters Association, but was my press secretary, and I had that initial book, and then I started rewriting it about 2 years ago, and had Dave Gurin and Pete Weichlin, 2 very talented people, to work with me on the book, and started writing, and never knowing whether I'd ever complete it or not, because it takes a lot of focus, a lot of discipline, and wondered whether I had that in me, but I did.
You tell a lot of stories in the book. You're quite honest about it. You particularly talk about the last time you were with your father, and it did not end well, and you were about to be sent to Vietnam, but then tragedy intervened. You didn't go to Vietnam, but you did lose your dad. Was it difficult to write about that when you sat down to put that in the book?
You know, it was. I was stationed in Fort Gordon, Georgia, got my orders for Vietnam, and my father spent the last 2 weeks of his life with me at Fort Gordon, and just a few days after he left me, after we'd had a verbal exchange.
Yeah,
we really did, because he was thinking about running for governor the 4th time, and I was worried about it. I didn't say no, but I was worried about it, and so we had some harsh words about it, but he had such great accomplishments in those 3 terms. I didn't want him to do anything to tarnish those accomplishments and achievements, because he always comes out as one of the greatest governors in the history of Tennessee, and served for 10 years. Only John Sevier and William Carroll served longer than he did as governor.
Children of prominent politicians and people that are well known often struggle in their lives trying to live up to their fathers or their parents. How difficult was that for you? Particularly, your dad was such a noted orator. He was the keynote address speaker at the 1956 Democratic Convention, and a lot of reasons that thousands of people showed up at your dad's rallies was what a great speaker he was. And did you feel like you had to emulate that? I know you took.
Well, I knew at a young age I wanted to go into politics. I did it a little bit differently than Dad. Dad knew at 16, I want to be governor of Tennessee. And everything he did and said from the time he's 16 to age 32 were toward that one goal and objective. I knew I wanted to run for public office, but I didn't know what I wanted to run for. And so we did take different roads, but both of us were very interested in and being in public service. And I've always felt like I had a special gift, Pat, to solve problems and break through the bureaucracy and get things done.
You did run for governor in 1978. You lost to Jake Butcher in the primary. Looking back in the book, you say the reasons you thought you lost were you got in the race too late, you hesitated, and also because you had a baby face at the time.
Well, I did. Matter of fact, even the Jackson Sun talked about Bob Clement and my baby face. It said, all babies look like Bob, you know. And so, I did look young. And my grandmother, Maybelle Clement from Dixon, Tennessee, commented about that too. She said, Bob, you were older than your dad when you ran for governor, but you look so much younger. And we did a survey after the governor's race, and it said, well, Bob, you're right on the issues. You had a good organization. People thought you were honest, but you looked too young.
Now, you focused a lot on the primary, but do you think you could have beaten Lamar Alexander that year?
You know, who knows? Who knows? And it would have been a tough race. It was a very divided primary. But remember now, I came within 30,000 votes statewide of getting the Democrat nomination. And Lamar had lost to Ray Blanton 4 years before, and so he'd been somewhat tarnished. But and I will give Lamar a lot of credit. He went around asking people, even in the primary, if Bob Clement doesn't get the nomination, will you support me? Did that with Carl Jones at Johnson City Press Chronicle and others, and he picked up a lot of support.
We're talking with former Nashville Congressman Bob Clement. He's written a book called Presidents, Kings, and Convicts. We're talking about the book and about Bob's life. Back to continue our conversation with him after you watch these messages.